missed the big free throw. Would have cut it to three, and the Knicks have gone from there and have opened up their biggest lead. They got to separate.
Yeah, well, see, Newman is right in Aguirre's face, and Newman does not want to back down.
And Dennis Rodman returning to the Detroit bench. The lead is 11 for the Knicks. Newman goes up.
Easy there.
That's getting closer now.
That time, that was a foul. Newman beat Aguirre off the dribble. But as they went down into the thing, Newman came back with his right hand.
Joe Dumars is checked into the Detroit lineup.
Now watch as he gets fouled. Now there, it's over. Now watch. You see the backhand right there. See, that's what started it. Newman reaching back with his right hand.
And a technical foul has been charged.
Now, if you're a Knicks fan, you're saying, wait a second. He was fouled. Very hard foul.
Technical foul called against Johnny Newman, and Isaiah Thomas will try to get the point. And it's a 10-point game now, 94-84. Who is not rated one of the top defensive players, to say the least, in the league.
See, you got to go in here, right
there. Up against Newman, Aguirre gets the foul, went right at him.
Mark Aguirre, in his career, is a 24-point-per-game scorer. Here with Detroit, he averages 14. When he's in there, he's as good as any post-up guy we have in this league.
Several of the Knicks had to pull Johnny Newman away, three of them, because Newman wanted to go after Aguirre. So this thing is still simmering here.
You know, Del Dick, see, if you're a Knick, Newman cannot be drawn into this trap. You don't need technical fouls. You don't need to get thrown out of this basketball game right now because you're an excellent athlete. And you do not want to give Detroit anything for free. Please keep your composure and play strong.
Matchup was working nicely for him. Malone penetrates and he's fouled. And Malone pushes Mahorn, so here we go. Tepper's starting to get a little bit high and tense right early.
But Timmy did the smart thing. He pushed and then he backed up rapidly.
he didn't stay in the heat.
Tepper's just a smart guy.
Yeah, Malone.
You see, and here's where it was a case. It's a case where Jeff Malone was out of control, but did the smart thing, threw up the shot. And after he pushed off, he backed out of there about 20 feet away, which is a smart move.
No question about it in the replay, though. The Malone did throw an elbow.
Well, you know, it was a soft one.
On Utah and the LA Clippers, rough stuff. Mike Brown, James Edwards get tangled up. No punches. No ejections, no fun in the front row. There were technicals assessed to both guys. Right now, the Clippers with a 36-30 lead over Utah at the LA Sports Arena.
Dann die Intensität zu. Coleman trifft nicht in den Ring. Kukoc mit dem Rebound und dann trifft Coleman den Ball nicht, sondern nur den armen Tony. Kukoc musste am Auge genäht werden. Mit der Handkante. Erst eine Rasur auf der rechten Seite und dann spaltet er fast Arm und Bein des Kroaten. Klare Entscheidung, Coleman musste in die Kabine. Kukoc war nochmal mit dem berühmten blauen Auge davon. Dann wieder zur Sache, 115 Kilogramm gegen 92, Mason gegen McKee. Aber bis auf zwei technische Fouls passierte nicht viel. Zurück.
A Saturday night fight in Orlando has resulted in fines and suspensions for Greg Kite of the Magic and Ronnie Cicely of the Heat. The two went at it in the closing seconds of the first half in Orlando on Saturday night. Cicely is going to be down here somewhere with Greg Kite on top of him. Kite labeled the aggressor in the fight. was fined $7,500 and suspended for two games. Cycli was docked $5,000 and suspended for one game. So he's not in there tonight as Miami plays host to Portland.
Steal on the right flank. Hollins takes it in and draws a foul.
These Trailblazers really...
There's a pushing under the basket, Don, right there between Steele and Brown. Jake O'Donnell in to break it up.
Peppers.
And this will happen so often in the ball game. When things aren't going right for you, you have a tendency to lose your composure a lot more quickly than you would if things were going right for you. So there's a foul call, technical foul. There we see Hollins making the move. He sees a little bit of opening here, a little daylight. He tries to force the issue, gets through, picks up the foul. Gus Williams hit him with the body. And let's see, right there are Steele and Brown. As you see in the left part of your screen, is where they got into it.
Again here.
Larry Steele, a veteran player from Kentucky, has taken good advantage of some hot tempers from Seattle early in the game. John Johnson got angry and ran right over him, was called for a charge, and now Fred Brown continues to throw words on him as Lenny Wilkins, a man who never loses his cool.
They're putting on. They're way ahead, and they're still picking up full court in the back. Look at that.
And they've got it right here. Dennis Johnson and towards it, going after it. Not a very good choice by Dave Forsyth, I'll tell you that. Johnson's awfully big out there. The official's right on top of it. The player's trying to break things up. Things a little heated out here. I don't know what happened to Dave Forsyth.
He upended Johnson when he was coming up the floor. All right, we welcome our other viewers. Here's what just transpired at Portland. Dave Forsyth and Dennis Johnson flipped each other in the air, and then they started up.
They were battling pretty good. It looked to me like Forsyth was the one that initiated that situation. Johnson just tripped over a little bit. Dave lost his composure a little bit and went after Johnson. And I would have to say, if anybody was the cause of that altercation, it certainly would have to be Dave Forsyth.
So now we have the officials who are working the game, and quite nicely, Jake O'Donnell and Jim Capers going over to tell both coaches just what we have here. Going to be some people leaving or what? We have 9 minutes to go in the fourth period. Don Cricky with Rick Ferry. Portland is blowing Seattle out right now.
Ball goes to Threet. Here comes Cooper. Here comes Threet. Threet all the way. Blocked, and down he goes hard and green. What are we doing? We got a fight started? Uh-oh, yep, we have. McDaniel gave Green a little bit of a shove, and Green shoved him right back. I'm telling you, this Green has got a new temperament. The first year he was in the league, he wouldn't have done that any more than I would have climbed the ladder and jumped off the top rung. I don't know what I want to see is what happened while Threet was on the floor. Riley trying to step in between them. It was right here in this building, right in front of us, and they're right in front of us now, that McDaniel came over and got the Lakers' little guard by the throat with both hands. You remember that? Wes Matthews?
Sam hits it. Big bucket by Sam Jones, putting Boston ahead by 3 points. Jackson lost it. Sam Jones. Foul by Gukas. Little fight going on there. Everybody's on the court. Here we go. Everybody's on the court. Chamberlain in the middle right there, trying to separate Sam Jones from Gukas. Actually, a good foul on Gukas' part. Sam would have had an easy layup.
Very intelligent play by Gukas.
Thank you. Despite all of the whistles, most players remain convinced of their innocence.
I played 14, 16 years. I don't think I never hit the middle foul.
And a select few have become infamous for trying to prove it.
Wait a second. Kevin McHale has never committed a foul since he's been in the league. You know that.
Yeah, there are nights where you get into it with the referee and it's much fun as playing.
I'm on the side of the players. I don't think we complain at all. I think there's just a lot of bad calls out there.
Me complaining to referees? How can people say that about me? I don't understand.
Oh, he's the biggest crybaby I ever met in my life.
The horn's going to be called for his third foul. And Tom Rick down, who's already got a tee.
I feel I'm a contributor to a lot of the NBA functions.
Now Charles is history.
Travel waves goodbye to Charles.
Well, I believe if a guy make a bad call, I let him know it. I don't worry too much about technicals.
They can change uniforms, but the NBA's elite complainers are always recognized by their fans.
If you talk to the fans in Philly, LA, Milwaukee, Detroit, you know, they'll tell you he was a crybaby, whining, spoiled brat.
Though they may sometimes be short on patience, they never lack for explanations.
A lot of times, maybe I'm just BSing with the guy as much as yelling at him.
Everybody fouls. You know, it's just something they catch and something they don't. So what's the sense in complaining about it sometimes?
Well, I got a great relationship with the refs.
Perhaps these players would lead a less stressful existence if they followed the advice of Moses Malone, who hasn't fouled out in over a decade.
No, I don't want to talk about that because it might be a jinx.
Come on, Moses, what's your secret?
Me? I love the ref. Best all time. The greatest. You know, sometimes they make great calls. And they make bad calls, but you know, you got to deal with the ref. I love the referees. I think they do a great job for the NBA.
10-point lead very quickly, and now just lead by two.
Chris Webber talking to Jim Clark and saying, hey, Mason is just manhandling people down there.
I think it's so interesting, the mind games that go on, because the Bullets just yelling and yelling and yelling at the officials.
Steve, at this point,
para San Antonio, Rod Strickland, saiu James, perdón, John Salley, y cometió la sexta falta, vaya golpe y le pegó a Strickland. Esta que van a ver. Quedaron momentáneamente mancados sus dos hombres, no chan. Sale y que sería directamente al banco porque era su.
Man on the floor for the Knicks are Mason and McDaniel. Starks. And he was fouled.
Well, I would think that Pat Riley's eyes are telling him that McDaniel is not making a presence enough in this game. Xavier's out there. But I don't think the Bulls are feeling him that much. Starks on the drive going left baseline. Getting clobbered.
Livingston called for the...
DSF, Freitag, 19 Uhr.
He dunked on me, then, you know, he kind of stood over me, embarrassed me, so I got mad. You know, Coach Thompson told me it was after the game, and he was happy that he dunked on me because he knew that I have a lot of pride and I was going to come back. And, you know, just what I did, came back strong.
Own dream team by Charles Barkley. Well, he's 6'5", Charles.
Deporte definitiva de los mejores.
Nuevamente le han obligado a efectuar un tiro difícil a Aguirre, que fíjate lo enfadado que está y le acaban de pitar.
Pod tablicami niewątpliwie Barkley.
No niewiele brakowało, zabrałby, chciał pokazać, że pokazywał timeout. Któryś z kibiców był przeciwko, lepiej z nim nie zaczynać, jest nieobliczalny. Jak to było?
Wcześniej było. Nadepnął na linię, ale a, nadepnął...
And the ball goes up and then you're ready.
Here it is! Wham! There you go!
That gets the crowd on his feet.
5:39, Horace had 24 and Charles was fired up in search of support. Tom Chambers misses, Barkley the offensive rebound, he had 13 boards.
Easy jam, Hornacek with his ex-teammate Dan Marley and Manute and Barkley, a big bat reunion arena. This is a good one. And Barkley battered and bloody, still had a great first half, throws up the three ball and that goes. And then when Cedric Ceballos misses the foul shot, watch Barkley fly into the lane and stick it. Barkley playing defense here, making the steal and taking it the other way. 24 points in the first half and then some big defense on Terry Davis. That's not going anywhere except the other way. Suns by 12 at the break. The Mavs fired up.
Although fights back with a jump hook over Barkley. Charles thought Mutombo, though, pushed off. He doesn't like that. Of course, Barkley letting the ref know about how he feels. It's important, but ref says, that's nice, Charles, but you're out.
Richie Dumas the dunk, and I'll lead to that, says George Foreman.
In our preview is Kendall Gill of the Supersonics. Last week, he was granted an indefinite leave because of clinical depression. He has been released by his team in order to seek treatment for this illness. Since he was granted leave, Gill has said his illness has nothing to do with the game and is caused by a biological imbalance, and he may be back playing as soon as next week. For a lot of this season, there have been a series of problems on and off the court between the 6'5" guard and his team, the Seattle Supersonics. Gill has spent a lot of time arguing with coach George Karl over playing time, constantly complaining that he isn't given enough. Before his medical leave, Gill played in 67 games, averaging just over 29 minutes. Although he is not a high-profile scorer, his talent will be missed.
Two player of the year in Ron Artest. Now, by Artest, and he's held up from behind. Two more free throws for Kobe. He can get there.
And we talked about Baino going to his left hand all the time, because he can't go the other way effectively. Kobe is doing all this going to his left hand. You don't know how to play him because he can go left, he can go right, he can go middle, he can go up, he can go down. That's why he is the man.
2 minutes now.
Walker with the steal. Here's Adams with Anthony back. And Michael Adams gives the Bullets a 4-0 lead.
Nice play by Kenny Walker, igniting that 2 points.
Oh, look out. Tom Gugliotta and Charles Smith having words. And now Oakley steps in. Smith and Gugliotta exchanging bumps out of midcourt, and it continued.
Most unusual from those two personalities.
Quick to get onto the court, and then Charles Oakley could be hit for third man in if this were the National Hockey League, as he stepped between and made contact with Kenny Walker. All right, here's how this got underway.
Well, some words preceded that push by Charles Smith.
They actually bumped out at midcourt, and it led to that.
But neither player would be described as fighters and troublemakers, so to speak. And it's so unusual to see Gugliotta and Charles so hot right away.
And apparently a technical was called on Smith. And that is it. And you saw the technical foul shot converted.
So much pressure off.
Ewing with 11 points. Now the matchup is Mason against Coleman. By Coleman, good save by Mahorn, and there will be New Jersey in possession with five on the shot clock. Butch Beard reminding his club, only 5 seconds on the 20.
He plays a lot of guys at a lot of positions, and we saw in the game against Seattle with the final seconds, he was on Ricky Pierce, and helped win the ball game for the Nets. Coleman, foul will go against Charles Smith.
They got a legal D on Anthony.
So the attacking Charles Smith will inbound. technical foul called on the Nets. It's on Coleman. By the way, if you haven't heard yet, Sports Channel, second channel, is now NewsScore, a brand new 24-hour sports news network delivering scores, highlights, and updates throughout the day. Plus, you'll see Nets action, Isles, Devils on NewsScore when there's another game on.
I'm a gracious host, courteous, genteel, and now I'm inviting you for the weekend.
Enter the baby Ruth.
Schroeder's a little upset. He'd been called for walking. Looked like he popped the ball off his bicep at the referee when after Jake O'Donnell had called. Sippy sort of knocks the ball off his arm right here. I don't know what he says. Right here, he pops it off his bicep.
Penetration has problems with it.
Boy, look at this trapping, scrambling Seattle defense. Seven on the shot clock. Bullet pass. Johnson inside to Barkley, who is taken down on a pin by Nate McMillan.
Well, you're right, though, Bob. They are really scrambling. And, you know, I talk about trapping areas on the floor. And when you get over on the sideline or down the corner, Seattle's really going to come at you, and they're going to try to take the next pass away. They're going to get in denial. If you can go back to KJ, KJ with nice patience that time finds Barkley underneath the basket.
Kicks to Marshallonis. Rebound, Sean Kemp. That's 15 rebounds.
Come playoff time, what you're seeing right now is how people are going to play the Sonics. They're going to make you shoot the outside jump shot. If you don't turn the ball over, if you don't let them get out and get in the fast break, and you force them to shoot the perimeter jump shot, they become a vulnerable team. I asked George Karl before.
Rick Fox, dazu dann Kobe Bryant und Sean Rooks. Und sie haben weiterhin von außen die Phoenix Suns und weiterhin die Trefferquote sehr, sehr mager. Und weiterhin Joe Klein damit beschäftigt, Shaquille O'Neal an einfachen Körben zu hindern. Eins plus für Joe Klein im Fach Hack a Check. Damit macht er sich nicht viele Freunde, vor allem nicht in Los Angeles, aber so ist nun mal sein Auftrag, seine Mission für diesen Abend. Und die Entscheidung kam jetzt sehr, sehr, sehr spät. Ein Flagrant Foul für diese Aktion da. Müssten die Schiedsrichter
sehen, dass Dennis Rodman dazu in der Lage ist, zumindest zum Teil Karl Malone von seinem Spiel abzubringen. Foul gegen Kobe Bryant, begangen an Danny Manning. Haben wir das Ganze nochmal. Hat Manning Glück gehabt, da hat er sich selbst in eine schwierige Position.
Tim Floyd, in seiner ersten Saison Cheftrainer in Chicago, muss $5,000 Strafe zahlen. Floyd hatte zwei technische Fouls innerhalb von 10 Sekunden bekommen. Floyd hörte nicht auf zu meckern und flog kurzerhand aus der Halle.
And then a conversation with Popovich with 11 on the shot clock. The Wolves doing a good job of getting back on the defensive transition. As we see a hard foul, and it's going to be Spurs ball out of bounds. 6:47 left in the first quarter of play. When we come back, Avery Johnson shooting free throws. The Spurs lead the Timberwolves 8-7 from the Alamo Dome.
John Williams. Natürlich auch, um Charles Barkley da Platz zu verschaffen unter den Körben, aber sie brauchen ihn auch, um Offensiv-Rebounds zu holen. Na, Barkley wird 33 im nächsten Jahr und ist immer noch kein Waisenknabe. Technisches Foul gegen Searcher. Ah, und er ist der Dirigent. Der Karajan hätte seine Freude dran gehabt. Charles Barkley dirigiert das Orchester der Phoenix Suns.
Ja, ja, und da kam mal ganz kurz der Hinweis, die machen keinen guten Job am Sessel, den Sitzgurt, den beim Auto hat man die Dinger normalerweise, ne? Gurte, also anschnallen hätte ich jetzt fast gesagt, denn jetzt geht richtig rund. Spannende letzte 6 Minuten stehen uns bevor. Das kann ich versprechen, jetzt geht's ab. Anschnallen. Technisches Foul gegen Sam Cassell. Und natürlich gleich wieder eine leichte Diskussion mit den Schiedsrichtern. Das bringt nichts, da kommt höchstens noch eins oben drauf. Er ist ja auch für seine ruhige und besondere Art bekannt, Sam Cassell. Ein Highscore. Da, der hört gar nicht mehr auf. Er mag sich gar nicht mehr einkriegen. Und hier der Grund dafür. Er ist sich sicher, dass er gefoult worden ist. Und bei dem wir da eingezeichnet haben, wo die Hilfe kommen muss. Das ist ein bisschen wie ein Gedränge beim Rugby gewesen. Müsste Ballbesitz für die Suns geben. So, jetzt haben wir nochmal die Situation. Gut verteidigt von John Williams. So, Barkley schiebt da erstmal den ersten Rocket zur Seite. Ewing loses Rasheed Wallace. Patrick Ewing's an elbow to gain position is called for his fifth personal foul. And now Ewing, as irate at an official as I've ever seen, he's been ejected. Two quick technical fouls, Patrick Ewing has been ejected. It was a fifth foul that... Chris Webber had his exchange with the officials earlier. And Patrick Ewing's night is done. Ewing is ejected with back-to-back technical fouls with 11 points and 7 rebounds. The officials have done a nice job of taking the stars out of the game, haven't they, John? Tim Legler misses the free throw.
That could be an interpretation. Patrick on the move to the basket.
Charles Oakley did his best to keep Ewing from going at the official, but there was just no stopping Patrick. There was one tee, and then when he took the step toward the official, there was the second.
Patrick not getting the calls he wanted, and he has certainly been as expressive, to say the least, in the direction of the officials this season, as many players have, of course, but we've never seen Patrick lose it like he has this year.
In fact, technical foul has just been called on John Starks.
That's ridiculous. I mean, that was missed so badly. You got to let the player express himself as Ewing tries to calm John Starks down.
John Starks. Crowd reacting to the announcement of the technical. Aaron McKee will shoot the tee.
I mean, Starks wasn't ranting and raving. He might have been saying something, but he wasn't. He shot a moment ago. No whistle.
Many Knicks players and the coaching staff made the point that it will count, and the foul. Foul on Ewing, who is upset. And he's hit with a technical. And he better be careful.
Somebody better get in front of Patrick and get him away.
Now Hoffer does just that. The young official, Monty McCutcheon, making the call and slapping the one of the best.
Patrick wanting a long explanation. Now you'll see a bump here. There it is. Continuation play. Patrick has greater sensitivity because this man is one of his closest friends and he wants to outplay him. You know that. There's a lot of ego at stake here between these two players.
Christie tried to hit Starks on the move, and Johnson is fouled. Fouled by Christie.
Nice exchange there with Christie and Larry Johnson.
Pat Riley has just been hit with a technical foul. Pat Riley very upset and has been ejected. Pat Riley has been ejected. And seemingly calmly, calm fashion, heads back to the dressing room. He'll finish the game as the Knicks head coach. Double technicals on Riley, who has been tossed for the first time since two seasons back in a game against the Milwaukee Bucks. Monty McCutcheon, the young official.
Vendredi soir. En retombant, c'était à Boston. Et là, il se foule la cheville. Indisponibilité prévue au moins une semaine.
Oh, it was fight night again in the NBA, this time in Indiana. Watch. Vern Fleming of the Pacers goes in for a layup, and former Husky Detlef Schrempf and the Knicks center Patrick Ewing get tangled up. Take this, take that. No, take that, take this. Anyway, they both got thrown out of the game. Uh-oh. Well, then as the game continued on without Ewing in the middle, Indiana had the advantage.
Good defense by Foster there on Weber's attempt at the jump hook. Isley floating it in the lane. Ball tipped back by Pollard, and Maxwell is hammered by Isley. Maxwell holding his cool.
Now the old Maxwell might have went after him. Smart move right there. Look at the rebound. Look at the tip. Maxwell holding his own. Oh. And way to hold the temper, because I know you.
Big play, A.C. Green flying in off the break, blocked by Sprewell, who thought he got all ball. The refs called a foul, Don Nelson can't believe it. Sprewell jaws and then gets rung up with a tee. Fourth quarter.
Thursday in practice, a collision. Would they return? That afternoon, the Aerials, the Browns.
Drives and misses. Nick Anderson gets the board. Workman working him over. An elbow. They push, they shove. But unlike the Heat and Hawks, no fighting. Workman gets whistled for the foul. Cooler heads would prevail. Heading towards half, the Pacers are up four. The Magic get hot.
We should have won the game. It was 76-71, and we made some crucial mistakes. And I love you, too.
Shot pulled down by Robert Horry, but Carl Herrera lets Olden Polonese have it. The refs discuss the issue, and Polonese not ejected. Herrera was tossed, so the Rockets lose another man. Late second quarter, Vernon Maxwell wanted a foul, didn't get the call, and he wasn't happy about it. Went after the official, and he was ejected, and when asked to leave, threw some ice out on the floor. The Rockets
for a 3-1 lead in the series, but Jordan was throttled all day long. Watch as he drives three or four Pistons over there, hammering him and forcing.
The NBA will not try and stop this week's grievance hearing over the Pacers suspensions in last month's basket brawl. An arbitrator is set to rule on whether the league's commissioner can be overruled and if David Stern had just cause for the penalties he imposed. The NBA is stepping back saying, go ahead, make your decision. If the arbitrator rules against the league, it will take its case to federal court.
Wenn man die Baseline zumacht, dann hat Mutombo kaum Variationsmöglichkeiten und dann sieht er schlecht aus. Avery Johnson mit viel, viel Drive zum Korb, wieder einmal. Und Foul gegen Denver. Da, mit Dampf zum Korb. Und das Foul geht an Rodney Rogers.
Club and
You never know what your future may hold.
Plays of the Week is delivered by Federal Express. For documents, packages, and freight worldwide, our most important package is yours.
Son coéquipier, Dennis Rodman, à 17,3, pas mal. Le top contreur, les Arriérois francophones, Dikembe Mutombo. Presque 4 contre par match. Not tonight, baby.
Pero Charles puede ser su peor enemigo. Su ignorancia es una maldición. Su descuidada imprudencia transmite falta de control sobre sí mismo.
La légende du roi Charles est né Iver. Il est fort en l'air et fort en gueule.
Frustrated right now. I can't even put it into words how bad I feel. I mean, it's that bad. Most of the people out there, they don't understand. They think it's just a game you play. This is your job, and you really care about winning and losing.
It was terrible because losing is just the worst feeling you can experience as an athlete, I think. I felt like I had let people down, and that part kind of shook me up a little bit.
Barclay commence à être tourmenté par toutes ses défaites. Philadelphie traîne une réputation de loser et Charles finit par se voir à l'image de l'équipe.
That was a bad time for me. I mean, I ain't lying. I didn't think I was gonna make it. I didn't think I was gonna make it, and I will truthfully admit that. I thought I was gonna go crazy.
La franchise de Barclay ne lui permet pas de cacher sa frustration. Lui qui était l'un des joueurs les plus populaires se sent devenir le vilain petit canard de la NBA. Incapable de sortir Philadelphie de son trou noir, Barclay se désespère. Il semble se désolidariser de l'équipe, sa rage de vaincre se transforme en amertume.
You want to stay with this team?
I just want to win, man. I just want to win.
We are the best team in the world. Let's go, baby. Let's win, man.
Mais la fatalité a voulu que le roi Charles ne soit pas couronné. Il se brûle les ailes en s'approchant trop près du soleil. Jordan lui fait de l'ombre, les Bulls de Chicago s'emparent du titre en 6 matchs et Barclay se retrouve face à ses vieux démons.
You kind of, that's the call between a rock and a hard place. Because you want to say it was a great year, but you feel so bad right now.
Mais cette fois, Barclay digère sa déception. L'opinion publique change au rythme des victoires et des défaites. Mais lui, le roi Charles, a trouvé une nouvelle philosophie.
I don't look at myself as like a failure because we didn't win the world championship. You know, hey, we gave it all we had. We played as hard as we could, and that's all anybody can ask of you.
Aujourd'hui, il sait que ses problèmes de dos vont raccourcir sa carrière, alors il doit faire vite, se dépêcher de reprendre sa quête du Graal. Charles Barclay n'a rien perdu de sa rage de vaincre. Qu'on se le dise, le roi Soleil a encore la force de conduire son armée jusqu'à la victoire finale.
Tide Iverson, Notwurf. Und check mit dem Rebound. A foul, Tyrone Hill. Hätten die Schiedsrichter auch weiterlaufen lassen können. Er nimmt sofort die Arme hoch, durch Zufall ein.
Wenn er spielt, dann mit hundertprozentigem Einsatz. Dennis Rodman wie einst der Schneider von Ulm.
Oh, there goes Rodman and there goes some fans with him. He hit the front row seats and at least two or three chairs with customers in it are down.
Jerry's Tech House. Lange vermisst, endlich wieder in Form. Marcus Camby mit 2 seiner 20 Punkte.
Und der Maverick stimmte. Eduardo Nájera.
Auftakt in diesem Spiel. Fast Break, Jackson und Miller. Hautspiel von McIlvain.
Jim McIlvain with his second personal. Two on the Nets.
Zweite Foul von McIlvain. Grob zugelangt, aber das ist eigentlich seine Art. Er kann nur grob zulangen. Wahrscheinlich der untalentierteste Spieler überhaupt in der NBA, aber er verdient immerhin 35 Millionen Dollar in 5 Jahren. Wer ihm diesen Vertrag gegeben hat, der muss normalerweise sich ärztlicher Behandlung und Pause darf er sich nehmen. 9 Punkte bisher bereits zu diesem Zeitpunkt, aber sieht eher nach einer Zwangspause aus. Ja, eine kleine Narbe.
Er zeigt mit den Werten, die er hat, sollte das eigentlich kein Problem sein für Dirk Nowitzki, dieses Jahr beim All-Star Game dabei zu sein. Technisches Foul gegen Juwan Howard. Und er fühlte sich da gefoult, beschwerte sich, ähnlich wie John Stockton in der ersten Halbzeit. Ein Freiwurf für die Utah Jazz, ausgeführt von John Stockton. Noch einmal die Aktion, Howard. Relativ sauber von Kirilenko. Und dann Juwan Howard, das ist wohl mehr der Frust über
Davis. Und deswegen schätzen sie ihn hier in Toronto. Er ist ein Arbeitspferd, Antonio Davis. Allen Iverson offensichtlich mit einer Entscheidung der Schiedsrichter nicht ganz einverstanden. Deutete einmal in Richtung Korbanlage, in Richtung 24-Sekunden-Uhr. Schiedsrichter kontrollieren. Und da haben wir das Problem. Das Spiel läuft, aber die 24-Sekunden-Uhr steht. Das war der Grund für Allen Iversons.
Dabei ist doch Reggie Miller derjenige für die letzten Sekunden. Und was passiert da? Die wahrscheinlich umstrittenste Schiedsrichterentscheidung des Abends. Und Jalen Rose regt sich da auf vollkommen zurecht. Eine katastrophale Fehlentscheidung. Was ist passiert? Reggie Miller beim Einwurf. Er spielt den Ball Longline. Der Ball geht ins Aus. Und nicht Mike Mathis, der Hauptschiedsrichter, der da in der Mitte diskutiert, sondern sein Kollege entscheidet hier, dass Jalen Rose den Ball berührt haben soll und nicht etwa Jerome Kersey. Und das ist leider komplett falsch gesehen worden vom Schiedsrichter. Rose regt sich auf. Wir sehen es hier, da ist der Referee.
Für die Phoenix Suns, Randy Johnson, Pitcher bei den Arizona Diamondbacks. In dieser Woche ausgezeichnet als der beste Pitcher in der National League. Aus der nahen Mitteldistanz. Meistens 2 Punkte für Glenn Rice. Rodney Rogers hat die Hand von Big O abbekommen. Oliver Miller.
Ostertag. Er bringt sich da selbst in Schwierigkeiten. Hätte er sofort selbst hochgehen müssen. Stattdessen nimmt er das Dribbling. Bringt sich selbst weiter unter den Korb. Damit in Schwierigkeiten. Und damit automatisch seine Mitspieler in Schwierigkeiten. Denn jetzt gibt es ein Offensivfoul gegen Malone.
Ja, teilweise eigentlich dann am Freitag um 17 Uhr in DSF.
Zurück zur Halbzeit Nummer 2 aus Portland. Und die Gäste aus Minnesota direkt mit der ersten spektakulären Aktion von Kevin Garnett, dem Mann der ersten Hälfte, vor allen Dingen mit einem überragenden ersten Viertel. Und das kann er ja zum Korb ziehen. Er ist unglaublich schnell, er ist athletisch, wird noch gefoult dabei und geht an die Freiwurflinie für den Bonus-Freiwurf. Das ist ein typischer Kevin Garnett, Emotionen pur. Ein leidenschaftlicher Basketballer.
Und die Gäste führen mit einem Punkt Vorsprung. 84-83. Stephon Marbury verlegt, aber Kevin Garnett mit Tippdank. Minnesota führt mit einem. Der Korb zählt. Ein Foul kommt noch dazu. Und ein Freiwurf für Kevin Garnett. Eine Schlussphase, die an Dramatik kaum noch zu überbieten ist. Nochmals das Ganze. Marbury legt ab, der Korb zählt und das Foul gegen wen ist egal, der Schiedsrichter hat entschieden, Rumstritt ist er. (Applaus) 22 Punkte für Kevin Garnett. Es war nichts mit dem Foul bei seinem letzten Korb. Aus Seattle, aus, vorbei. Die Minnesota Timberwolves gewinnen gegen die Seattle Supersonics mit 85 zu 84. Kein Leckerschmecker, was die Qualität des Spiels angeht. Aber es war an Dramatik.
Weiterhin eine Mannschaft.
Sein Assistant Coach war da gerade noch mal an seiner Seite zu sehen. Und Siggi kommt. Sean Bradley hat im Aufzug in Bremen bei einem Vorbereitungsspiel zur Europameisterschaft von seinen deutschen Nationalmannschaftskollegen den Spitznamen Siggi bekommen. Sean sei zu wenig deutsch, jetzt heißt er Siggi. Das nächste Foul gegen Dallas entschieden, gegen Michael Finley. Zweites Foul gegen Finley. Ja, da der Blick, das war schön zu sehen da gerade, der Blick von Jordan, die Augen, die zeichnen, renn du nach vorne, du kriegst das lange Ding. Das war sehr, sehr schön zu sehen hier. Mit einem kurzen Blick zur Seite hat er gesagt, Lou, du marschierst ab, dann kam der lange...
Charles den Wunsch, seinem Kumpel Michael Jordan in Washington auszuhelfen. Er sei bereits bei 140 Kilogramm Kampfgewicht angekommen. Noch 10 Kilo runter und der nächste NBA-Dino wäre bereit zum Comeback. Wenn es Sean bedeutet, kleiner Krieger. Das ist ja nichts Neues. Aber durch diese Übersetzung bekommt Hacker Shaq eine völlig neue Dimension. Immer auf die Kleinen. Zuletzt gesehen im Spiel Bulls gegen Lakers, als Shaq Schläge einstecken musste, mit denen andernorts... Für das Hacker Shaq Problem ist das noch nicht, aber was ist die Lösung? Sonst hole ich meine Brüder.
Let me say you something, man. My name is Shaquille O'Neal. I'm the third brother of Shaquille O'Neal from the Los Angeles Lakers.
Also, that was the star backcourt you had to go up against. The whole state of Arizona just has great jackets. Lost a little shuffling going on here between Herrera and Garnett. They get after each other. Carl Herrera. Standing his ground with Kevin Garnett. Good kind of things that have to happen sometimes also. Maybe better get Garnett a little bit out of his position exactly for playing this game.
Side off the Mike Brown pick into the lane. Stockton stops. Oh! Edwards, he will go up and jam it home. And Edwards throws a right hand at Michael Cage, and I think we are going to have a little fracas breaking out here. Michael Cage wants a piece of Blue Edwards, and Edwards wants to go at Michael. George Karl restrains Blue Edwards. Mark Wunderlich, one of our three officials. And then Edwards from behind threw a right hand at Michael that grazed his flank.
All right, here's Edwards on the shot coming down. But he did get a little push from Cage, and they got a push back. So let's see how they call the foul, whether it's going to be a double technical or which.
Well, it was a shove from Blue Edwards from behind.
Rappelez-vous le jour que John Starks a dunké sur Jordan et Horace Grant en finale de conférence la saison passée. Flying, skying John Starks. Bravo, Isaiah et merci.
Let's go, Edwards. Thompson with the rebound. And Isaiah commits the foul, and it gets hit with a technical foul.
Isaiah knows it. He's
leaving the game.
He popped the mite of it. You'll see it right here. See, what we have here is total frustration. Here they come down on a rebound. See, Thompson gets really upset here, and Isaiah hits him and slaps him on top of the head.
That's a punching foul, and you're out of the...
I don't think KJ's picked up a technical since he's been here. George and Rodman's getting into it.
Once again, you don't want to allow Dennis Rodman to get under your skin. Don't
foul's been called on Rodman. They should give him one just for his hair.
Yeah, he had a tough night last night. Alonzo was picking on him, and now Dennis Rodman is trying to do him harm.
And Gerald Jackson converts the free throw. The Bullets have only shot three free throws in the first half.
Mirasan, but not good blocking out.
Strickland goes around Jordan and gets flipped.
Now they're going to get Dennis Rodman with that. He backed underneath. He backed underneath Rod Strickland. A dangerous play. The only question I would have, did Rodman do that unintentional, or did he actually see Rod Strickland going towards the basket?
Rodman over the years has acquired the reputation of being a cheap shot artist, particularly when he was in Detroit.
That's why I find it so ironic. He's here now, and the team that he created all kind of havoc against their teammates.
The answer is Philadelphia. He had a pretty good all-star game.
Uh-huh.
Happy to be there. You can tell that he was.
Whoa! Cassell and Finley.
That's on Finley. He throws an elbow at Cassell, trying to strip the ball and take it out.
Technical foul, Dallas number 4, Michael Finley.
Sam, I think, realizes that is somewhat uncharacteristic of Michael Finley in the final analysis.
See, now you hear the whistle. He wants to hold the ball. Sam wants to take it out and give it to him.
They come into Madison Square Garden, it's going to be a dog fight.
It had no bearing on the shot. Carter is fouled, and he went down hard. Collins and Mim now having a chat. And Collins still...
Don't need it now.
And Vince Carter is visibly upset as a timeout is taken. And Chris Mim went for the slap. This was the play in question.
Well, that's a swing and a miss, and unfortunately he didn't miss Vince's head, and that's the reason for the flagrant foul. Any kind of contact with the head, you have to call it, even though in an unintentional he was trying to go for the basketball, but he made contact with his head, and that's a good call. And then technical for jawing at each other. Collins coming to the rescue of his teammate.
Now Vince Carter got up and was angling himself.
And as Aufbauspielers, sie sind unglaublich gefährlich.
So, jetzt gibt's eine kleine Rangelei.
This quarter, Berry to Weber inside, driving on Rice. And a foul called on Glenn Rice of Los Angeles. That's the first on him. Another flagrant foul, perhaps. It was. But that's this almost, time on Los Angeles.
Kevin, that's almost like the baseball rule that Mike McMoney over here is very well familiar with. When the pitcher throws the ball and hits your man, then you've got to hit him at the other end. Weber was called down at the other end for grabbing somebody, and now they get him at the other end.
Little chin music there, Danny.
Yeah, I think that's a good call. Clean the game up early on. It's not going to make or break the game right now.
Minnesota, Stacey King, d'ailleurs, qui marque plus de points avec Minnesota, presque 12 par match.
Hubert Davis. En face quand même, hein?
C'est vrai. C'est dommage qu'ils ont perdu Doc Rivers, leur meneur titulaire, pour toute la saison. Et là, il y a quelques règlements de compte. Le Pete Myers qui paie les pots cassés.
Il y a quand même. Oh.
Quelle interception de Vernon Maxwell et une faute sur lui, bien sûr.
Et une faute comme d'habitude en NBA. On ne veut pas laisser un joueur va jusqu'au bout tout seul. Il va payer.
Vernon Maxwell. Le beaucoup réussi par Houston ces dernières années.
Vernon Maxwell qui a mis 51 points dans un match contre Cleveland l'année dernière. Avec 14 sur 25.
Mon 7 pour les Lakers.
Lakers balle en main, Byron Bing. Scott.
Et voilà, on l'a pas très bien vu. Mais à mon avis, c'est Rudd.
Rudd, me semble-t-il. Touché sur cette action, on va voir ce qui s'est passé au ralenti. Ah oui, voilà.
Boum, voilà, il a rencontré un mur qui s'appelle AC Green. Boum!
Épaule contre la tempe.
On fait courir la défense et Worthy marque à 3 points. Pourtant, il tente assez rarement sa chance. Et bon, là, on se retrouve avec Malone et AC.
Il remonte à la ligne de fond comme pocos. Mais esta vez no contaba con la cama que le iba a hacer la defensa de los Grizzlies.
In Heimspielen gegen die Lakers haben die Sonics 13 gewonnen. Also Selbstvertrauen werden sie haben. Und klasse gemacht, Payton. Und der zählt nicht, das Foul vorher von Kobe Bryant. Das ist nicht das Zeichen für allergrößte Harmonie. Nicht, dass da an den Gesichtsausdrücken von Kobe Bryant und vor allem Nick Van Exel richtig interpretiert habe. Sie sind nicht zufrieden mit dem, was sie vor allem defensiv bisher abliefern. Und Kobe Bryant sieht da ein ums andere Mal schlecht aus gegen Gary Payton. Aber die Lakers kommen ran. Fox. Schon wieder eine Niggeligkeit, ein Offensivfoul und ich glaube ein Ellbogen von Robert Horry auf die Hüfte von Gary Payton. Also im Duell dieser beiden war das ganz bestimmt nicht das letzte Wort. Da hat Horry ihm, wenn ich das richtig gesehen habe, in der Geschichte, in der Szene, da gerade den Ellbogen gegeben. Da hinten, ja, man kann es hier nicht sehen, aber da war was, auf jeden Fall. Er ist sogar so angeschlagen, dass er gar nicht richtig losgehen kann auf Robert Horry. Gary Payton das Offensivfoul gepfiffen und er wandelt am Rande des technischen Fouls. Nicht unmittelbar gegeneinander spielen, aber die mögen sich nicht besonders. Die Geschichte ist schon ein paar Jährchen alt. 10 Punkte Führung, knappe 4 Minuten noch und das wäre der dritte Erfolg im dritten Aufeinander. Das macht ihm jetzt richtig Spaß. Das genießt er und er haut die Aktion. Das Selbstvertrauen steigt, er pusht die Mannschaft auf und haut dem Verteidiger das Ding ins Gesicht. Eine Fallstudie. 9 Assists für ihn, da haben wir es. Und dann schauen wir eben.
Banging around with Vinny Askew.
Williams to Brian Williams. Inlow to Mutombo, will cut into the lane. Then he comes over, goes chest to chest with Askew. Then Detlef Schrempf comes over with some words from Mutombo. And Nate McMillan will walk in between those two.
Well, particularly with the conversation we had with Magic today about the Nick Van Exel situation, going to the line and keeps coming right at Nolan Fine and should be ejected for bumping the referee. No place in basketball for that, as Magic clearly told us before the game.
Magic was talking about how
that in this league, mental toughness is what separates the men from the boys.
Pippen lost his cool for a moment.
The Pistons return to the NBA Finals for the third straight time.
In the 1991 Eastern Conference Finals, Scottie would show once and for all that he could face the pressure with the poise of a veteran.
No matter what they did or what they tried to do to frustrate me or take me out of the game, that, you know, I would get up and shake it off. I just kept giving all I had, and I knew before long that, you know, they would have to accept the beating that we was given.
Aguirre with Paxson and Pippen racing down.
In their last encounter 11 days ago, the Bulls and Spurs brawled, clawed, and battled to the bitter end, only to see the champs and the great one prevail. The rematch is next.
Larry received a special tribute from his close friend, Magic Johnson.
Larry Bird said that,
I love this game.